Hello, hello, this is Ruben for Sonokinetic, and in this video I'm going to be taking a look at Sonokinetic's Grosso in detail. If you haven't already, be sure to take a look at the Grosso overview video, where I'll quickly run through some of the main features of the instrument, because in this video I'll be getting into the nitty-gritty of Grosso. So let's not waste any time and dive straight in. To demonstrate the different aspects of Grosso, I've actually loaded up all of the patches. I've got strings, woodwinds, brass, percussion, and choir. There is one other patch which is a transition builder, but that has its own dedicated video. So I'll be demonstrating a lot of these aspects with the strings, but where applicable, I will delve into some of the other patches as well, just to cover them briefly if they differ in any way. So the first thing to realise is that Grosso is a tempo-synced phrase-based library, so that means that all of the phrases contained there will tempo-sync perfectly to your DAW. We'll cover that in a little bit more detail in a bit, but the first thing you'll want to know is how to load phrases and get them playing. So I'll just solo the strings, and within strings there's three different fields, 1, 2, 3, and four different presets. So you can play one preset at a time, or you can change them just by clicking into the interface, or by using key switches. In the case of the strings there, C, C sharp, D, D sharp, but they're actually different for each of the instruments. So with woodwinds, for example, the key switches are here. Because the five Grosso instruments all have different key switches, it means that you can load them all into one instance of contact, just as I've done here, and then you can switch patches and turn mutes on and off on the fly, all with these different key switches. So have a look in the manual for the exact locations of all of these key switches, or you can click the information button, and that will also tell you strings, woodwinds, brass, percussion, and choir. I'll be referring to this chart now and again, just to give you an idea of where things are. So let's have a play so you can hear what's happening. Here we've got three different phrases loaded into the three different fields, and they'll all play together when you hit a triad on the blue section of the keyboard here. Major and minor triads are recognised, and all of their inversions as well. What you heard there is the three different phrases playing. Now, these phrases can be changed just by going into the phrase picker. So you just click a phrase, and you can change it to any other. And you can solo the individual fields or mute them with these mute buttons here. You can also solo just one field by command or control clicking. And here we go, field one is just playing. Often more than one phrase will have the same graphic. So you can click here to choose the others in the selection. There's two here, so let's choose the second one. One really fun feature is that you can click the O of Grosso here to choose a random phrase from the selection available. Give it a try yourself. So you can already see how flexible this is becoming because you've got three different phrases that are possible in each preset and four different presets in this case. The default for Grosso with any of the patches is that you have high and low sections and sometimes mid as well. With strings you've got high, mid and low. With woodwinds you've got high and low. Brass is the same. Percussion has two sections, orchestral percussion and taiko ensemble, and choirs back to three. However, you don't have to stick with those configurations. You can actually load any phrase into any slot. So you just go into the phrase picker and then click these tabs at the side here. So for example, if we wanted three high phrases playing, we could do that. And let's choose variation four in field three here. So let's have a look at the individual controls within any field, and they're all the same for all of these 12 fields in the case of strings, or 8 fields with woodwinds, brass and percussion. So I've already looked at the muting options. There's also the option to purge the samples, and this is intelligent purging. So if the phrases are used within any other field, they won't be purged, but otherwise they will. And you can just click here to purge. Click again to reload the samples. This is the harmonic shift control. So you can turn that on and choose a harmonic shift value. I'm not going to go into harmonic shift in any more detail here, but there's a full video dedicated to that. And you can see that video on the Sonokinetic website at www.sonokinetic.net. You've got mod wheel volume control. So as standard, all three of these fields are set to be controlled by the mod wheel in terms of volume. However, what you can do with this control is actually set it to off in some fields and on in others. What this means is that you can have some fields fading in and out as you control the mod wheel, and others will stay at the highest volume. So listen here, and I'll fade in and out field 1, which is the highest strings, with the mod wheel, and the other two fields will stay at a constant high volume. So that's really useful if you want to create ever-evolving, changing phrases. The other control here is the speed control. So you can click this icon to change the playback speed of the phrase relative to your host DAW. The phrases will always sync to your host tempo, and they'll be time stretched within contact to match the BPM of your track. So just click through for the different options. This will play at the original recorded speed. You can play at double speed. You can play at half speed. Or the most useful mode is really this one, it's intelligent tempo mapping. And it will play back at the recorded speed normally, but at extreme tempos it will play automatically at half or double time. Just so you know, all the phrases in Grosso were recorded at 135 BPM in 12/8 time. So this is the equivalent at 4/4 of 90 BPM. So that will give you the original tempo, but most phrases are completely suitable for any speed of project. So there's one other option within the field that I haven't looked at yet, and that's this score view here. So I'm just going to solo the first field. And I'll go into score view, and you'll be able to see exactly how that's notated. And I was playing in F, so that's the F notation. You can go straight in and look at any of the keys. There's a full PDF of the score available for purchase on the Sonokinetic website. So most keys are available in all keys, major and minor. There's some which are just in major, but we've mapped those to minor parallel scales. And there's some phrases which are atonal. You can look at major, minor. Just give you an example of the atonal one here. As you can see, they're all the same for this one. And whichever chord you play, you'll get the same phrase. And just be aware that the whole A section has no minor version, and it's also not mapped to a minor parallel, it's just gender neutral, so it will sound exactly the same for major and minor. There's just one other thing to mention as I was going through the muting options there, is that the mutes are all available as well on these key switches. So high velocities over 84 will make the fields live, and low velocities will mute them. And again, just click into the info panel, and you'll be able to see exactly where these muting keys are. So let's turn to the global controls now. They're accessible just with this icon here, and these are pretty straightforward, so I'll just run through them. Each field has an independent volume level, and you can adjust those up and down here. Just click and drag, or you can control or command click to set them back to default. Panning is the same, but drag left and right. Again, control click will bring them all to the center. The next control is for crossfade times. Now again, you can drag this left and right. And I'm going to cover it in a little bit more detail in the tempo syncing video. But just to give you a rule of thumb, for fast phrases, you're better off having quite short crossfade times. And for longer phrases, you might want to move those up so that you get a smoother transition. This is really an option that you'll have to experiment with, depending on the phrases that you've chosen. I'll give you a quick example with woodwinds. So here we've got a kind of long flowing phrase. You can hear that sounds a little bit strange because the crossfade time is very low. So if we bring that up, it'll make the transition a lot smoother. As I say, experiment with that and see what works best for you. I'm just going to turn to the brass to explain the next setting. This is for microphone positioning. Now we've got several different microphone positions, decatree, close, wide, and far. And you can choose just one by clicking on the legend here and just choosing none in one field and one in the other. Let's hear far, for example. Deca, Close. And wide. You can actually mix between two different microphone positions if you'd like. Let's hear that in action. Don't forget this uses twice as many voices in contact. So if you're short on resources, you might want to just set up one microphone position, or you can use the Grosso light patches that we've also provided. And within these, we've pre-mixed a 2T position from the other microphone positions. It's worth remembering that other Sonokinetic libraries, Vivace, Minimal and Decapo, also have the same microphone positions, so they'll blend really well. And those libraries also have different tuning options, and that's a feature within Grosso too. You can go for a constant pitch, 443, 442 or 441 Hz, or standard pitch, 440. The last option here is harmonic shift, and again, I'm going to go into that in a separate video in a lot more detail. This time around, within Grosso, we haven't provided an onboard convolution reverb, because the microphone positions that we've chosen really sound very special. If you want to, you can add a high-quality reverb on a separate bus. We'd suggest perhaps one of the selection from Ultiverb, but we'll leave that up to you. So it's worth noting that the percussion has some slightly different options. There's no harmonic shift, for example, because there's no need with percussion. And as you can see there, the percussion has very different kind of graphics to the rest of the instruments. And hopefully this should give you an idea of exactly the kind of riffs that you're getting. You can also check out the score view for more detailed notation, of course. I also want to give a quick mention to the choir. And within the phrase picker there, you can actually see the different phrases. There's whole phrases there, and there's also an option just to pick single words. There's also a selection of effects, just here. So I hope that's given you a good insight into Sonokinetic's Grosso in a bit more detail. Be sure to check out the other videos in the series, or if you've got any further queries regarding Grosso, check out support.sonokinetic.net or take a look at the accompanying manual. And thanks so much for watching.